We're continuing to monitor Tropical Storm Ada. It's been strengthening all day. Now max with sustained winds around 65 miles an hour. And it looks like we could potentially have a hurricane by the end of the day, if not as early as tomorrow morning. Here's the latest track on Ada. Looking like it's going to continue to intensify through the overnight hours, potentially making landfall. It's a pretty strong Category 2 storm overnight Monday into Tuesday morning, with max with sustained winds at around 110 miles an hour, mainly affecting Nicaragua as well as Honduras. But that northwesterly track could also affect parts of Guatemala and Belize by the end of the week. This system kind of slowing as it projects over towards parts of Central America. And with that northwesterly turn, this is something that we're really going to have to keep a close eye on, because that littlest curve, as long as it gets closer and closer to the Caribbean and the ocean, it kind of gives a little bit more of some oomph and energy. So again, something that we're going to have to monitor over the next couple of days. Gorgeous sunset this evening over on our Capitol Tower Sky Cam, our Vicksburg Sky Cam, our Hilton County Line Sky Cam. All beautiful conditions this evening. Highs today reached around 72 degrees. Lows this morning were a chilly 45. That cold front moved on through early this morning, leaving us with lots of sunshine and breezy conditions as well. We saw gusts today up to around 20, 25 miles an hour. That's going to sustain through the evening and overnight hours. But fortunately, by the morning, we're not going to see as strong of a gust, still around 10 miles an hour at time. But as we go through the day on Monday, those wind gusts really going to be subsiding, and we're going to be really nice and pleasant for your Monday. Again, a really nice sunset this evening on our Vicksburg Sky Cam. Temperatures going from 62 by 652 by around 8 o'clock. A chilly tonight as temperatures continue to drop, 48 degrees by around 10 o'clock. Now, I know it says 67 degrees for our high today. That was not the case. We actually ended up getting to 72, but that temperature drop overnight tonight is going to be getting into the upper 30s. It's going to be a cold morning. We're going to be anywhere between the mid to upper 30s and maybe a few low 40s in our southern counties, but we turn on the real feel values and we could be as cold as feeling like the mid 30. Some places in our northern counties potentially feeling like freezing by Monday morning. And then we get back into the upper 50s, low 60s for the afternoon. Election day going to be pretty nice as well, mid to upper 60s with a few low 70s. Election day looking pretty nice. Lots of sunshine starting off on the cooler note, 47 by 8, 62 by around noon. We'll get to around the low 60s by around the evening time. Fast forwarding into the end of the week, we do have a warm up. We're expected to be above average for this time of year. Going into the weekend and even to parts of next week, we'll have mild conditions with highs in the mid to upper 70s. And then a cold front is expected to knock those temperatures back down to around seasonal by the end of next week. So kind of to wrap things up, dry conditions expecting for the next couple of days, a little bit more cloud cover by the end of the week, temperatures going back to around seasonal by around Wednesday and Thursday with highs in the low 70s.